Talofa alawa fionga Aupito. Thank you very much for this opportunity. Firstly, let's start with your message for the community. What would you like to say to them at this time? Do you think people are taking this COVID-19 pandemic seriously?
I think people are hearing it, but it hasn't quite sunk in, the sense of urgency and the sense of need for preparedness. I don't want people to panic, but I do want people to take on board the advice that's coming from our clinicians, and that advice is going to remain constant right throughout this pandemic, and that is about washing hands. Washing hands thoroughly, the 20 seconds or the two happy birthday, sing it twice, making sure that after you wash your hands, they're dried. Wash it before you eat, wash it after use of the toilet, wash it when you're in contact, after being in contact with somebody, wash it when you're with somebody that's sick. That's the constant message throughout this. There are some messages that are coming out at the moment about congregations, public events of more than 500 or more than 100 internally. Whilst that's the message, we're banning and looking at those numbers. It is a call to our church leaders, our cultural leaders, to renew how we conduct all of our events, whether it's religious, cultural, family, funerals, you name it. It's a call to renew so that what this is about, it's about all of us looking after each other, all of us preventing the spread of the coronavirus.
Yeah. So what's your message for the churches, the schools? I know that some people might be having a funeral. What's your message for them?
Well, look, ultimately, the church leaders must make a strong call on this. My advice is when we're saying we're banning 500 and we're banning 100 congregated inside, what we've got to do is relook at what are the ways that we need to protect each other. There are two examples that I would like to highlight. One is the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, where globally they are no longer gathering in congregations or wards, that every family are conducting their Sunday services within the confines of their home. The Pope is the other example, where he is delivering his sermon online and inviting people to join him online rather than gathering as usual. And so that's an example. There are other advice that's coming out of our clinicians about not touching, not handshaking, not the kisses and the hugs. And I know that's going to be really, really difficult because...
With our Pacific culture, that's how we... It's the
Pacific way. It conveys love and affection. And I'm saying, just say, I love you and do the air boom and walk on. And as funny as that might be, this is really about not allowing this unseen enemy to spread and affect our communities.
Do you think it's going to be difficult for our people because we live in big households? You know, we talk about the distancing from each other as well as self-isolation. How do you think our Pacific community will cope with that?
So at the moment, what I've done is I've asked the Ministry for Pacific Peoples to work closely with the Ministry of Health. And so you've got La Ulu, who's heading Ministry of Pacific Peoples, and a wonderful team that they've got. You've Dr. Debbie Ryan, who's now been called on board by the Ministry of Health. She's now quickly put a team together, and now we're identifying a Pacific Experts Advisory Group. They will be the ones that will be engaging with our community, making sure that the high-level messages from our Prime Minister and our government gets transmitted as quickly as possible in a way that our peoples can understand the importance and the depth and apply that in our daily practices. That requires working together with our church leaders, our Pacific health providers, all of our community providers. I'm asking them, we've got to work together, and the aim here is to make sure that we take the truth and the messages from our government and apply that in our own circumstances so that we're saving lives, that we're keeping people safe, that we're keeping people calm and protected. There's too many unknowns in the future, but we know that there are constant messages of cleanliness that has to apply, but it's now an opportunity for us to renew all of our cultural practices, all of our church practices to keep everybody safe.
I know safety is obviously important, but also people are worrying about their jobs. You know, there's talks of people losing their jobs. You know, this week there was a big announcement. Yeah. How will that help our people? There are bills to pay, people on the benefit?
Absolutely. So the government's work now, everything is being done with the COVID-19 lens. The first package, there's threefold. The first one is about putting more money into our health system in the tune of $500 million. And that's about recognising our work, our staff, our tools, everything that they need, our health providers. They are really running ragged at the moment, and we don't know how long this will be. And we also, it's about recognising that we've got to take care of our elderly, our vulnerable, pregnant mothers, people with underlying sicknesses. That's what we've got to deal with at the moment. That's why the flu epidemic, flu vaccine is required. But then we don't know what will fall out of the COVID-19. The second part of that is about helping business brace the first thrust of what's coming. And that is helping businesses in order to sort of see how long they can sustain their practices for and to redesign their plans. And part of that is also protecting workers, protecting self-employed, protecting those contractors. And then the third phase is about the most vulnerable. So it's the $25 extra for beneficiaries, the doubling of the winter energy payment, and the support for working for families. That's the first phase, $12.1 billion, unprecedented amount. But we realise that we've got to look at other things that are gaps there, to make sure that the economy continues to roll through. And so work that's happening at the moment under the leadership of Minister of Finance is looking at the next budget, which will be another phase of continuing this work. Everything that we will be doing as a government will be seen in the lens of COVID-19.
Yeah. Let's talk about the Pacific region now. We're closing the borders. We're basically saying, don't travel. What are your thoughts on that?
Our people have got to heed that. And if you travel, if you don't heed the advice, we can't guarantee supporting you because our consular services may not be available to support you. So we've closed the borders as of last night. The exemption will be families, citizens and permanent residents. There'll be exemption, and it'll be for humanitarian health workers. There'll be exemption on some cases that'll be taken on a case by case under that lens of humanitarian and health. We are saying do not travel overseas. And so you must heed that. And we hope that you heed that, because at the moment, Fiji is confirmed. Samoa probably will receive some advice tomorrow. That is confirmed. And so at the moment now, this enemy is starting to spread out there. And we've really got to be cognizant of that and do all we can to stop it, because we've already seen what happened in Samoa under the measles. The country, the Pacific Island nations' health services may not be as well resourced or as strong as some of ours. At the moment, our focus is internal. The global nature of this pandemic means all countries will prioritize their own citizens. All of our country's health workers will be called upon to help our individual needs. And therefore, you know, we're not going to be in a position to help those who don't heed the call and the strong advice that's coming through.
Yeah. Have our Pacific leaders been in touch with our Prime Minister and yourself for help? Because, as you mentioned, not everyone has the resources, and we have to send the tests away overseas before we can confirm.
And so the government are working through a couple of initiatives coming from the Minister of Foreign Affairs. And at some stage, more announcements will be made. I'm confident that our missions out in the Pacific Islands are in close contact with all of our Pacific Island governments. As I say, if you look at it, the lens that this is a global war type situation, all countries must prioritise their own people. And unfortunately, that's the situation that we find ourselves in. We're taking best advice from World Health Organization. We're taking best advice from our experts. We don't want anybody to panic. We are prepared for this, but and we're doing everything we can to stop the spread, and we need everybody on board.
There's a lot of uncertainty at this time, Minister. What's your message, for our people in terms of supporting each other, looking after one another, caring for one another? You mentioned the panic.
Mm-hmm.
What would you like to say to our people?
Don't fear. Be prepared. You know, and really, that's I'm confident that we've got the best experts at hand. I'm confident that our clinicians on the ground, our providers are working hard to prepare for a community outbreak that may occur. Every resource that we have is now focused on preparing to slow the pandemic, to slow how it spreads out to a community. And so mistakes are going to be made. And so the message that the Prime Minister says, we've got to show kindness. We have to stay in contact with our elderly. And church leaders got to take some responsibility. Our elderly will not be in contact as usually, so call in, find out how do we connect on them online. And that's some of the discussions, and I'm hopeful that our community leaders, our church leaders will start thinking about. Our Ministry of Pacific Peoples and other ministries will also be providing some guidance and seeing how do we do this better going forward. But it is about showing kindness. It is about if you're sick, particularly if you're coughing and feverish, don't get involved. Stay home. If you protect yourself first and foremost, then you're in a position to protect others. And so that's the other message.
Well, Faftai Tele Lava, thank you very much, Lafionga Minister Aupito. Mm.